Hello guys, today I want to share one of my favorite games with y'all. And this is not a game that I usually play, but this is a puzzle game. And I really like puzzles, and once in a while I come across a game that, well, is kind of fun to play. So this is Glass Masquerade Origins, and you can find this on Steam. It's quite cheap, as far as I recall, and I fell in love with the soundtrack and the look of the game. And I think this is absolutely gorgeous. So I have completed the entire game. I also bought all the DLC, so all the downloadable content. It was super cheap, it was like $2 each, I think. And also they are making a Glass Masquerade 2 called Delusions. You can see it up here. And if you click on it, you will just get to the Steam page. And I am super hyped. It will be released sometime in, I think, November of 2018. So I'm really excited for that. But I just want to show you a bit about how the game works. So if you'd like to get it, you can do so. So I'll put the Steam link down below in the description box. And also, please be aware of spoilers, because I will show you a couple of the completed puzzles now. So if you don't want to see that, I suggest that you just go to the Steam page immediately and have a look at the trailer and stuff like that. But I will get into the actual game. So the thing is that you are experiencing art throughout the entire world. So you will begin in France, I believe, where you complete a puzzle, and when you have done so, you will unlock more and more puzzles around the world. So as you see here, I can go to Britain, Germany, Sweden, Iceland when you begin in Europe, and then you can cross the oceans to go over to America. The very golden icons are the downloadable content, so Finland was one of those that I bought very recently. I completed that just a few days ago. I thought it was very fun to have Sweden here, since I am from Sweden, and I was very happy to have some Vikings. And they are all of different difficulties. Some are way more difficult than others, and some are very easy. So the ones in Europe tend to be quite easy, all of them, since they are in the beginning of the game. And as you go down to, I think all of those in Africa were quite difficult. If I look at the Congo one, it took me almost 22 minutes to complete this one. I had a lot of difficulties. I just couldn't find where everything was supposed to go. And you might think that every single mosaic piece is a puzzle piece. It's not. I'm going to show you one of the puzzles. But there are a lot of puzzles. It's 35 all in all, with all the downloadable content. And all the puzzles are absolutely gorgeous. Trying to see if I can find someone that's very nice without clicking on everyone, so I won't show you all the spoilers. I really like the, let's see here, Argentina, Brazil. Trying to remember which one I was going to show you all. I think that this one was very interesting. It was difficult, kind of difficult to lay, like it took me almost 10 minutes, but very pretty. And this one I had difficulties trying to find my way in. But it's a Seox chief, and I think it's a gorgeous piece. If we have a look over at, let's see here in Asia, I think South Korea was one that I really enjoyed laying. I really like the motif of this one. It's so pretty. China I thought was quite difficult as well, but it didn't take me too long to finish that one. It's absolutely mesmerizing. So since I'm from Sweden, I'm thinking I should show you all the Swedish puzzle, so just show you how this works. And I can replay this over and over again. So when I get into the actual puzzle, I have this frame, and I also have a couple of red pieces, which will help me to begin laying my puzzle, because they automatically turn to where they're supposed to be, and all the puzzle pieces do this, which make it kind of difficult to know what piece you're supposed to pick when you begin. So like this one, I'm guessing, is one of the frames, which it is. And this, of course, is one of the easier puzzles going into the game, so this will be quite easy to solve, I believe. I have not done any of these puzzles in a while, or this one I haven't done in a long while, so. But it's very easy to find where it's supposed to be, and some puzzles are very much difficult, according to me at least. But I'm not a puzzle pro at all. I just really enjoy puzzles and solving riddles. So I am very fond of this game. Let's see here where this is supposed to go. No. So if you don't want the piece, you can just drop it immediately. Was it someplace around here? Oh, there. Oh, no, it isn't. Let's see. There. And everything is counted for in time. I don't really care about the time right now, since I'm doing this mainly to show you what the game is about. There. And the soundtrack is amazing. It's made by a composer named Nikita. Oh, something on S. I did check out his website. The entire soundtrack for this game is lovely. I think there are a couple of different tunes around. So I did this in 1 minute 42 seconds, new record for me. But I really don't stress while doing this. This is so relaxing for me. I really love this. So I just want to give you all a short look around in this absolutely gorgeous game. And I hope that you will have a look at it if you think it's something for you. And you don't have to get the downloadable content. I was just craving to get more, so I bought it all as soon as it was released because I was so happy to have it. And there are 35 absolutely amazing different motives to do. And well, I absolutely adore this game. I will play all of the puzzles again and again and again. So yeah, I just want to show you all how this worked. If you liked seeing this, don't forget to leave a like and leave a comment so I know to make more videos like this and show you some of my favorite games. And if you haven't done so already, don't forget to subscribe to my channel so you can see more games. And that's all for me. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you all next time.